No question about it. One of the hottest commodities in professional wrestling, Hollywood Hogan. But Mike, like anybody else, I was a big Hollywood Hogan fan for a long time. But what this man has done over the last few months is become more and more violent, more and more vindictive. He is angry, and losing the World Heavyweight Championship to Goldberg in the Georgia Dome sent him right over the edge.
I guess we all should have been prepared, Scott. Maybe a case of premature celebration for WCW fans after Goldberg's world's title victory, because as you can attest, since that night at the Georgia Dome, it's been all NWO Hollywood.
I don't get near any of the guys in the NWO black and white. They are angry, and even though they have the U.S. strap, the world tag team straps, even tonight, backstage at Saturday night, they're still just as angry and ornery as anybody I've ever seen. I don't even like getting near those guys.
And how about this? Our broadcast colleague, Lee Marshall, is going to be conducting an interview later tonight with Kurt Hennig of the NWO Black and White. And I understand that Hennig and all of his NWO Hollywood members are still celebrating from last Monday's Nitro event in Salt Lake City.
Well, they didn't invite you or I to that celebration, and I wouldn't have gone anyway, I don't think. In the ring on Saturday night, the huge Roadblock will take on that man, Lash LeRoux. Our first look at the Lasher on Saturday night.
A programming note for Superstation viewers. Due to the Goodwill Games, Thunder will be preempted again this week, but then Thunder returns on Wednesday, August the 5th, from Casper, Wyoming. And a note to fans in Casper, tickets are available at the Casper Event Center box office, as well as all the usual outlets. And then Thunder on Thursday, August the 13th in Fargo, North Dakota, with tickets available at the Fargo Dome box office, Sun Mart, Discontent, Dayton's, and the NDSU Memorial Union.
The massive Roadblock just manhandling young Lash LeRoux here on Saturday night. Talk about dead end. Number one, that dead end sign on his tights, I think, is actual size. This guy is massive. Oh, Roadblock misses with the elbow charge again. LeRoux, the knife edge chops, no effect, and one chop from Roadblock sent LeRoux halfway across the ring. Good night.
Well, one chop with 400 pounds of strength behind it sent LeRoux flying. Oh, the big boot took him down to the mat in a hurry.
And the elbow drop. That is, oh, that's an amazing feat. That's a lot of weight to get up. Cover! How did LeRoux kick out of that? I don't think Roadblock was ready for that one to be over. Oh, no.
Oh, my. Just drop this young man throat first across that top rope. That's a steel cable that his windpipe just made contact with.
This just doesn't seem fair anymore when someone like Roadblock just scoop, just drops straight on top of Roadblock. Now what? Steps over the top rope.
Oh, we've seen this maneuver. Oh, he calls that the dead end. And you know what? It was for Lash LeRoux.
I don't blame him at all. Lash LeRoux barely moving as the Roadblock with the dead end. The backflip from the apron over the top into the splash on LeRoux, and that is it.
What an impressive showing. It is worth another 400-plus pounder here on Saturday night. There it is, using that top rope to spring back in, and then all of the weight landing down with a thud across this young man. Easy win for Roadblock and a dead end for Lash LeRoux.
Lee Marshall is standing by.